Marjorie Greene found something about the shooting to be aggrieved about. Not the kids dying, she doesn't care about that. Not the adults dying, she doesn't care about that. The fact that this is the 130th mass shooting of the year, doesn't care. 13th school shooting, doesn't care, doesn't care, doesn't care, doesn't care. She did care when one of her Twitter accounts was briefly suspended though, for spreading transphobic lies. She tweeted about this saying, "Yesterday, my official Twitter account was temporarily suspended for warning about Antifa's Trans Day of Vengeance in front of the Supreme Court. Don't even try to follow whatever the not even train of thought of what she's saying. It makes no sense. It's conspiracy theories and disinformation and lies and hatred. This planned event is being whitewashed by global brands and the left. Meanwhile, there's still no acknowledgement of the innocent Christians that were slaughtered in Tennessee by a trans mass shooter." Suddenly, identity matters to her when it comes to the first, you know, the 129 mass shootings that preceded Nashville this year that were perpetrated by 129 cis individuals. It was never worth mentioning, oddly enough. No acknowledgement of the innocent Christians, which seems weird. Kind of feel like we've talked about it a little bit, kind of feel like everyone in the media has been talking about it. The difference, I guess, is that our acknowledgement of the victims is coupled with an inconvenient, impolite call for changes to be made that make it less likely to happen in the future. Because while she is cosplaying caring about those kids, very briefly dying in a tweet, she does not want to do anything to stop it from happening again. So the next time a school is shot up and kids are cut down, whether it's a public school or a Christian school, she'll be there ready to make the most of it politically for herself, but only afterward. She's got nothing for the kids who will needlessly die. So sorry about temporarily one of your accounts being taken down. By the way, as last time, they left her regular account up. They're indistinguishable. There's no difference between the two. So I'm not even like, I almost wanted to give Twitter a little bit of credit for temporarily suspending her, but they reversed it and she was still spreading the same sort of transphobic hatred on her other account anyway.
She's upset about it because that's one of her vehicles to advance her political career and promote herself. Again, what they care about. If you gotta pay attention to these politicians, man, we already know it. Pay attention to what they care about. And what they care about is always themselves. It goes right back to the promotion of their careers. And the promotion of their careers is more money, more influence, more power. And then as they do the bidding of this gun lobby, that's part of that money. That's part about that that reelection juice and the campaign money they can get from them. They'll do their bidding for their own political careers. And they will laugh in your faces. We're living in the moment when people always talk about, yo, these politicians, the government's coming for you, the government's coming for you. You know how the government comes for you without actually coming for you? Handing everybody in the country guns and letting them shoot each other while they sit up on their hills, in their castles, in their moats surrounded with alligators in the water, and they keep you out while you're murdering each other, complaining about how they're gonna come down and kill you. Hey, guess what? We're already killing each other at a high, high rate. And those folks that are watching it happen are laughing about it. As you say, wait, you guys, we gotta keep shooting each other before the government comes down to kill us. It's happening. In case you wanna be a conspiracy theorist, your conspiracy is living your life, is living right in front of you right now.
Yeah, there's no conspiracy to the idea that the Republicans believe that they're supposed to occupy positions of government like a boulder would, exactly the same. Get there, stay there, do nothing, stop anything from happening. And then all the while your supporters say, we've been forgotten. You have been forgotten by the people you love the most. The people you go to the rallies and you cheer for them, they don't give a damn about you. To JR's metaphor about the castles, the only thing you need to add to it is that occasionally they throw a can of spam over the moat in the form of a culture war topic, and that's it. And then the barbarians sweep through and kill the lot of you. They throw another can of spam or whatever, and you worship them for the spam. That's what you do. It's utterly pathetic. Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.